All right, y'all, if you remember my piano hinge notebook from my last video, this is looking really great, but I want to add some charms and decorations to it. So what I've done off camera is I went ahead and printed on some shrink film. I got this, is a Silhouette brand, but you could use, I guess, Shrinky Dink brand as well. I went out and cut out a whole bunch of different, I printed them on my inkjet printer and I cut them on my brother's Scan and Cut. You don't have to use Silhouette products necessarily solely on Silhouette machines, as they would probably lead you to believe. So I just printed out these. I did trace them in Inkscape. It's a little bit of a process. You can probably find some free places to do it, but it did take a little bit of editing and whatnot to get the full shape. So I just went ahead and traced them in the Inkscape program to create a vector file so I could cut them out on my Scan and Cut. And so these are super cute and they're gonna get super tiny. So let's start off with this flower. You're going to need a heat-proof surface. So I have a piece of granite. This is actually a sink cutout that I inherited when my wife and I bought this house. So that is really great. It's sitting on top of a butcher block tabletop. I have the Sizzix kit for doing shrink film, which has the, grill and then the tamper holder in placer thing. I don't know. I'm sure it has an official name. And I have a heat tool. This is an older one, but whatever you have will work. So let's get started. All right, and I don't know if you noticed, but it looks scary there for a second, and it makes you want to be like, oh, stop, but just keep going after. It looks scary and curly, especially with the shapes that have a little bit more pointy things. It looks like tendrils and things like that. And look at that. That is gorgeous. Look at that. You can see it from either side. This matte side is the side that I printed on, and then this side is the opposite side where you have to peel the kind of facing off. So I'm going to go ahead and do this with the rest of the charms. This is going to look great dangling from here. We're gonna have a whole cluster. I'll get some beads out. It's gonna be a lot of fun and super cute. All right, there is my leaf looking great. Now you can bake these in the oven, and that is what the directions say. It says to bake them until they curl, and you can flatten them out with a piece of parchment paper. But I find instant gratification, especially with a heat gun, is much more to my speed. And look at that, that is so cute, so cute. There we go. There we go. All right, those are super cute. So all we're gonna need is, you know, this hole is a little bit further in, so we'll probably need, we'll do maybe some wire wrapping or something like that. Because I did use an inkjet printer for these, I think I will try to find a clear coat for these. I'm gonna see if I have some varnish or something like that. I think I have some clear engine enamel coating, which I think will be fine. It'll just a protective layer over this because you don't want this to get wet and smear. I don't know after it's heat treated how stable the pigment is, so just sealing it up will probably be very helpful. Now, before I take these outside, I want to kind of affix these to a piece of cardboard so they don't blow away. So this is just a scrap sheet of cardboard that I have kicking around ready to go to the recycle. And then I just have some straight pins. These are corsage pins, they're super long, but whatever pins you have on hand will probably work. And I'm just gonna put a pin through the hole a little bit, just to kind of, so when they blow around, they don't blow off of it. And it just helps me keep track of them just a little bit better. Just gonna put them in at an angle to try to get the best, I don't know, hold that I can. And so I'm just putting them around, just spacing them around. I feel like I'm taxidermying shrink film. Kind of funny. All right, let's go to a well-ventilated place, most likely outside, away from anything. All right, we're outside. I've got my engine enamel coating that I'm gonna be using because that's what I have laying around. Just gonna give them a quick coat and we'll let them dry. There we go, that's all it took. Hello everyone. All right, so we have our sprayed and cured shrinky dinks. So they're sealed on the back so the ink won't reactivate. And we have all of these ready. These look really good. They're shiny on one side and matte on the other. So this is going to look great. These look super cute. And we're going to create charms to go on your planner, on your notebook, on a keychain. Or if you've seen my other video, this piano hinge notebook that I made. And so I'm going to make them to clip on right here so they dangle and are super cute and fun. So let's get into this. Let me start pulling out all my supplies and I will list, I believe on this side, all the materials that you'll need. If you have done jewelry making, you should actually have a lot of the supplies that you will need for this, which is what I did. I actually have made jewelry for quite some time. I haven't necessarily recently, but I have a lot in my stash that I have, that I've used. I did go ahead and go out and buy extra hardware just because I wanted them to all match. I wanted black hardware and I didn't have a full matching set. And I needed extra big lobster clasps to go around those skewers. So that's what I have. Then I just have some pliers, some rounded pliers, wire cutters, and some needle nose pliers that I just have had kicking around for a while. And from my stash, I just pulled some beads that I had that kind of match the colors of the project. So let's get this off and onto a surface that y'all can see a little bit better. And this handy dandy tray is from the We Are Memory Keepers tray cart. And I'll link that in the description box below. It's really great for organizing your projects because I just put everything that I needed on it so I could go ahead and use it. All right, so I have some chain, I have jump rings, I have head pins. Let's see what else do I have. I have beads of all different colors. So I'm really trying to mainly focus on the yellows and the greens. So I have these green ones and these yellow ones, some white ones. I don't even know what that is. They're just in there. That, those greens. I don't think that green goes as well with that. Just some clear ones. Seed beads, whatever you may have, will work for this. So let's start building like a little dangle. So I have this chain, and then I also have some other chain, but this is too silvery, So, and I wanted black. So this is just some black chain I actually got from Joann's, and I will link that in the description box below, and it probably already popped up on the side for the supplies list. All right, so let's see about how long we want this. So this is it held up, so I want the lobster clasp is going to hang down a little bit. I don't want it going all the way down here, so we'll make a chain maybe about this long to right about there. So the nice thing about these chains is that you can actually find the split in them, and then you can open it up. All right, let me zoom in so y'all can see the little split in the chain, and you don't have to cut it. You just have to open it up. Oop, and I dropped it. Let's try that again. So on this chain that I want to take off, I'm gonna go ahead and grab it and find where it's split. All right, and much like you open a jump ring, you're going to not pull, you don't want to pull apart like this, you want to twist forwards and backwards. So you're gonna use two, and needle-nose pliers work best. You can open it like that. See, I just twisted two and forward and back. So apparently I need to do just a little bit more. There we go. And then make sure I have a good grip on it, and then just twist back. There we go. And now we have a length of chain. Let me zoom out just a little bit. So the first step is adding the lobster claw to this. Lobster claw clasp. It needs to be nice and big and chunky. There we go. Oops, two came out. That went back. Then I'm gonna put this on with a jump ring. I'm gonna use the mid-size jump ring, so not the smallest one, not the biggest one, but the mid-size one. You could attach this directly to the chain, but I don't think I want to do that. So, like we did the chain, we're going to open and close it by pushing and pulling, not pulling out, and then we'll attach this on there, and then we also will grab our lobster clasp and put that on there, and then we'll drop it. All right, there we go. Don't lose grip of your things. There we go, and then we have it on there, and then we will go ahead and close it back up again. Make sure to grip only the jump ring. And there we go. You have your lobster clasp attached to your chain. And this is big enough to go on your book and around some bigger rings, which is really what I wanted. So there we go, that attaches there, or it can attach to any number of things. I just find that the bigger lobster clasps are gonna be a little bit more functional because they'll go around a lot more things. So now what we need to do is we need to decide what charms or little shrinky dinks that we wanna add on this. So because this is the lemon one, and I wanna add, so maybe we'll add a lemon, we'll add a flower and a leaf. Or maybe we'll add this. You know what? We'll add the white flower just for variety's sake. We'll save these for another project. Maybe I'll make some extra charms off camera, and y'all see this at the end. But to go ahead and attach these to the chain, you're gonna wanna go ahead and grab another jump ring. I think the bigger jump ring is gonna be good for the lemon and the white flower. I'm sorry if there's any background noise in this video. Apparently my next door neighbor is getting their carpets cleaned, so the truck is outside making lots of noise, and I have my window closed, but it's very close. So once again, just go ahead and open it. So grab it and twist forward and back, and then go ahead and slide this one on. And then let's see, we want it kind of dangling a little bit, so we aren't going to attach it towards the top of the chain. And then we'll go ahead and close it. There we go. That looks pretty cute on there. All right, and I think I'll attach the white flower to the bottom. So I'm gonna use another big one. This guy is gonna be a little bit trickier because the pattern had a little hole in it. And so I thought it would be really good to have a hole there, but it's much longer than usual. So we're going to attach this a different way. So getting another large. And this one, you don't necessarily have to pinch it like this. You can hold it. You can hold them parallel to each other if that helps you. And then again, that forward and back motion. And then go ahead and add your flower. And we're doing the bottom link on the chain. There we go. And then closing this back up again. Gonna do this a little off to the side, maybe. There we go. Just kind of wiggle it back so it lines back up again. And there we have the beginnings to a very cute dangly charm. Charm dangle. Okay, so for this one, it's going to be a little bit hard. So first up, let's try our head pins. These have a nice circle at the bottom, so we'll see how big that is compared to our hole. And see if it goes through or not. These aren't very big, they're about an inch. So that is actually gonna go in perfectly. So then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to just kind of bend it up. And then what we're going to do, well, what I'm gonna show y'all how to do is to make a wrapped loop. So for that, you're going to need your round pliers. And we'll make this. And we said we put this on this side. So we will go ahead and add it to the chain. We want this up, and then I have to remember how to do this again. All right, I'm gonna try that again. All right, so for this leaf, what we're going to do is we're going to put this on a head pin and then create a wrapped loop at the top. So you wanna make sure that you leave enough space, and I'm gonna go ahead and start my loop right about here. And then I'm just gonna come over to the back side of the leaf and kind of wrap my wire around. My pliers. You might want to use another plier to kind of help pull and direct that. And then once it has gone around, you're going to want to twist it around the wire pretty as nicely as you can. Try not to scratch up your your head pin too much. And this is a little fiddly, so take your time with it. Could have gotten longer ones. Well, I don't know if I could have gotten longer ones in the color that I wanted, but this would go a little bit more easily if you had a longer head pin. But this is what I have to work with, so y'all can see me struggle a little bit. There we go. Let's see if we can get that around just a little bit more. I think it would look a little bit better. There we go. There is a nice wrapped loop, and then we are going to find a spot on the chain and we'll just attach this directly to the chain. I could have made it with the chain, with it on the chain, but that would be too many moving parts, so I decided against that. So there we go. There we have those. So I think maybe one or two beads added on here would be a really nice addition to this charm that we're making. So maybe we'll grab a yellow, and maybe we'll grab a white and a green. I don't know if I necessarily have a green that goes super well with this one. Has a nice yellow to it. If y'all are wondering, I actually don't know where a lot of these beads came from. I used to get, there was a bead hoard found, and so I subscribed to get them monthly. So these are vintage, if not classic, antique. These could be Australian crystals or something like that. These could be older Swarovski size. I don't know. I honestly don't know what they are. So maybe that one with that. We'll string that above there. Maybe we'll do a couple on a head pin up here. See if they fit on the head pin first. Sometimes you never know how big your bead is. Is this one a little broken? Yeah, that one's a little broken on the side. See, these have been kicking around for many years in my stash. So, and I could have received it broken as well. So we will have this head pin, and then here we go. I think three. I think we'll do three on that head pin. And maybe we'll only do yellow and white and we won't do a green, since I don't really have a green, an earthier green. I have very vibrant greens, but not any more foresty dark greens. This has more of an olive hue to it, so. There we go, and then we're going to make a wrapped loop with this. So, there we go. This is how you would traditionally make a wrapped loop. Take that, and then all the way around, and then you can wrapping. So we've made the loop. I don't know if y'all can see, we've made the loop. And then we have this tail that we're just going to wrap around this part right here. Usually end up doing this much closer to my body, so this is kind of hard to show on camera. try to keep your beads away from your wire as the head pin as you're spinning it around, because you don't want to catch and crack them. I definitely have done that in the past, but it can be a little fiddly to get it on there and make it go around in a nice, pretty manner. Again, these are a little bit shorter than what I'd like to be using, but it is what it is. If y'all can see that. We've got the little tail, and then we're going to make sure it keeps on going straight back. There we go, and then just, you're really just spinning it around that, the center of the head pin. There we go, there is our wrapped loop. Voila! There we go, and let's see, let's put it kind of close to the lemon. So, we'll put it a little magnetized. We'll put it on this link right here so that isn't the split end. There is the split end. This is not a soldered chain. This is a split chain, I think is the right term for it. And I would think most of the, in the jewelry supply section, most everything is split chain. It's not necessarily going to be soldered. So you can open it up and add your elements directly on. You don't necessarily have to add a jump ring every single time. Here we go. And the more you move your metal, the harder it will become. It builds up heat and friction, and so that's what it does. So there we go. We have our little yellow beads. And I think we'll attach the white one too. Let's make sure that this hole isn't too big for our head pin. Oh, I have plenty other. Oh, I totally overlooked all these beads over here. Oh my goodness. All right. Well, maybe we can find one that goes with the leaf too. So these, how, what I have this organized in is like the workshop screw organizers, like the really big ones. And so these are just the trays from it. So, no, I don't really see a green one. I don't know, maybe that. You know what, we'll do this clear one to go with that. Just so every charm can have a buddy, a bead buddy. Don't want them to feel alone. There are some fun brown ones that might be, I think that's glass. I don't think it's jasper. I think they're probably made to look like it. Those greens are really more grassy and a little less earthy, so. We'll do this one since it has a little bit of a green color to it, and I think the green kind of picks up on that. So back to the head pin. All right, let's make sure it's actually long enough as well. All right, there we go. So we're going to do the same thing, fold it over, and then we'll switch over to our round-nosed pliers, I believe is what they're called, and then just make it go around. I'm sure there are plenty of people that are much better at these wrapped loops than I am, but I am sorely out of practice on these, so you'll have to forgive me. There we go. There is another wrapped loop for the white bead. So we're gonna have this one closer to our white flower. So let's choose this link right here. There we go. That is looking charming, if I do say so myself. Look at that, super cute. All right, and then Leaf, you get a bead buddy too. All right, and there we have our third wrapped loop.
So let's put this guy, let's put this one near that. Let's just put it, you know, we'll put it above the leaf. Put it right here. There we go. Pop that link on the chain open. Bead goes on.
There we go. And that is how you make a charm. Look at that. Isn't that super cute? Look at that. That'll look amazing on this notebook. Let me put it on there. All right, there we go. Look at that. That is super cute and fun. You can make a planner charm or whatever you would like with that. Love that. All right, so as you can see, I have cleaned up my space and I have made a few more charms. So this is the one that I showed y'all in the video with the lemon and the leaf and the flower. I added the white bead, this kind of clear with a little bit of olive color to it, and then the yellow, and then I made another one. And this one I just made with a smaller clasp and ran it around one of the skewers and just made some, I'm just calling them like lemon drops, like little drops of lemon juice on that. And I still have an extra one. And then I made a couple more for some of my other planners. So I made this little group of lemons for my Teresa Collins Happy Planner. And then I clipped this one into my Franklin planner, which is super easy to do. I just clipped it with one of the big lobster clasps on the ring and then just tucked it over the top for a cute, fun planner accessory. And I just added some large jump rings with the same yellow beads on it. And I think these turned out super cute. I hope you do too. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow me on all things social. And I will see y'all in the next video. Bye!